Hey, I'm Yasmin Hendra. I'm from Selangor, Malaysia.
Hi, my name is Adipa Amrai. I'm from Selangor.
Hi, my name is Sabrina and I'm from Selangor.
My name is Aza. I'm from Penang.
Hola, you know me, Miguel. I'm from Selangor, Malaysia.
Hi, my name is Shiny. I'm from Ipoh Perak.
Hi, my name is Su. I'm from Melaka.
Hi, I'm Rudni. I'm from Penang.
Hi, I'm Harley and I'm from Selangor, Malaysia.
Nama saya Nur Syahira Yasmin dan saya berasal dari Kuching, Sarawak.
My name is Sasha and I'm from Melaka, Malaysia.
Back in 2015, La Banda, the first season, obviously. I kind of wanted to learn Spanish, so I thought what better way than through music and TV shows. I started becoming a fan after they released their first album, Primera Cita, which I thought the songs were simply amazing, and the CNCO album songs are even more amazing. They get better each time.
Listening to the Viva Latino playlist on Spotify, and I heard Reggaeton Lento, and I thought I really, really liked the song, and I was kind of wondering who sang the song, who are they, and it didn't sound to me like it was one person singing. And I began to listen to more of their songs, and after that, I started to kind of like them and try to get to know them better as a band and as people. I started to really like them and became a very big fan. I really look up to them. They are not the kind of celebrities who consider themselves celebrities. If you've had the chance to speak to them in person, you'll know they're just like normal people like you and I, and they're actually very, very nice.
On Spotify, I was listening to Reggaeton Lento remix last year. I went on to discover their Primera Cita album. It's so wonderful, their album is amazing. It was actually Volverte a Ver that got me so hooked and obsessed with the boys, with the band, especially Chris. If you guys know me, you know that he's my ultimate favorite. And I've been a fan for more than a year now.
It was like 2016, just randomly scrolling through YouTube, and I saw this guy. I just clicked on it, and it was their song, Reggaeton Lento. It was really nice. I was really impressed by their dance and everything. I was a fan, but not really that crazy fan, until like Little Mix did like a collab with CNCO, and that's when I got super wild about it.
Saya mula mengenali CNCO dari kumpulan Little Mix yang berduet dengan mereka dengan lagu Reggaeton Lento Remix. Bermula dari saat itulah saya mula meminati CNCO sampai dah sekarang.
I was like scrolling through Instagram and I saw a post by Little Mix saying they are collaborating with a band. So I was really curious because it's a Spanish band and Little Mix is a British gold group. I think the next day is the release of Reggaeton Lento Remix, so I just listened to it. I couldn't tell you, it's the best song in the whole wide world. It's like an anthem for CNC owners. I started listening to the original version of Reggaeton Lento and I discovered that it has 1.2 billion views, and I'm like, wow, this band is good. So I watch all their audition, I fell in love with them, with their voices. Honestly, just them.
I was a fan. When the Reggaeton Lento remix first came out, immediately I just picked up a little bit of it. It was really new, really good. I was immediately amazed at how talented the boys were and how good looking they were there, of course. I fell in love with how they sang, how they started dancing from there. I immediately searched about them in YouTube, and I just watched all their videos. The first video I took, it was Reggaeton Lento by them, and I was like, oh my god, I fell in love.
The first time I saw them, in of course, in Reggaeton Lento Remix, when YouTube suggested me to watch the music video at first. Reggaeton Lento Remix was my big jam for about a month, until one day I decided to Google to know what is CNCO, because of course they have the attraction. Their voices is so good. They are so talented. They can dance. Since the day I Google about them, I followed them to all their social media platforms.
I first heard about CSEO when Little Mix announced on Instagram that they were going to collab with CSEO on the remix of Reggaeton Mexico. So the first time I actually listened to CNCO was only after the music video for Reggaeton Lento Remix dropped. And I remember the exact date that I first watched the music video. On that day, I actually texted my best friend the link to the video. I joked to her saying, I don't know who these boys are, but I'm standing them. I said that as a joke, but look where we are now. 19th of September 2017. That date might sound familiar to you. It's the exact same date that CSCO arrived in Malaysia for the first time, the 19th of September 2018, which is exactly a year after Infusion. I didn't actually expect to like the song as much as I did. I never really listened to Latin music much before I discovered CSCO, but I fell in love with that song right away. I remember like a few days after discovering them, I already had the Primera Cita album saved in my phone and I listened to Sleep and all that.
Little Mix released their new single, Reggaeton Lento, last year and collab with a Latin boy band. It's intriguing, you know? So I started to search about them and stream their other songs. I fell in love with their voices and songs, music first, before I fell deeper with themselves as a person. I knew I was a fan when I started to keeping up with their daily life through Instagram and Twitter.
Well, it's amazing to see a whole bunch of fans in Malaysia asking for our song Reggaeton Lento on the radio stations. We're really happy that we got to do the collaboration with Little Mix. It was incredible. They're amazing girls, super fun and super nice and talented, and we hope to do something soon with them.
So it's crazy that in Malaysia they don't speak Spanish. So yeah. to let's hear them speak, ask for our song is crazy.
Yeah.
Super
yeah.
dope.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
We love you.
The NCO Malaysia was created. It was first and just an idea of me and Sabrina. We actually found out that Yasmin, one of the admins, actually created a Twitter of CNCO Malaysia right after I actually changed my Twitter handle from CNCO Malaysia to Lilac Joel at the time, I think. And I was like so, oh, like that. I was like, we need to do something about it. We joined forces and that's how CNCO Malaysia was created. I am so proud of how far CNCO Malaysia has gone, and CNCO has gone global and around the world they are known. Okay, and honestly, CNCO Malaysia is going insane with them, and honestly, I'm so proud of it.
Literally noticed the tweet and I was like I couldn't really believe what I was hearing, and I was like literally like shocked, and immediately I started crying and Asa started crying on the phone. I was so happy. I was literally jumping on my bed crying in tears, literally mixed emotions, and like yeah, that was the first ever moment when Joel noticed us. And I think that was when CNCO knew when they actually had fans in Malaysia, because I'm not sure if they knew. I think that was the reason why CNCO decided to come here, because they know that we had fans here. And that was how CNCO, like, I think they found out about Malaysia. So that was like the happiest moment of my life, and I'm really, really happy that I could share with you guys.
Malaysia, wow, even Malaysia? Oh yeah, wait, I think I followed a Malaysian account on Twitter. Thank you for supporting us.
Well, you guys might remember that in March, CNCO released Bonita as a promotional single of their self-titled album, CNCO. It was a few weeks before CNCO album itself dropped. They released it with the music video. This brings us to another favorite memory of CNCO Malaysia's. Before I get to it, just so you know, before this, before like Bonita dropped, Sony Music Malaysia has not yet promoted anything of CNCO's other than Reggaeton Lento Remix. And maybe Reggaeton Lento like way back then in 2016. But on that day, like a few days after Bonita released, about 5 days after, one of my friends, Gagan, she was a former admin of CNCO Malaysia. She sent a screenshot of a post from Sony Music Malaysia. It was a video of CNCO playing with Doug the Pug, and the background was Bonita. They finally promoted CNCO for the first time, and needless to say, we were like so happy because they finally promoted CNCO. And if you were one of the first few CNCOers in our group chat, you would know that we have been trying to get their attention, trying to get them to promote CNCO, and they finally did. I remember how we were like celebrating in the group chat at that moment. A few days later, I suppose, Sony Music Malaysia actually DM'd us saying that they wanted to promote CNCO more in Malaysia and that they wanted our help in promoting CNCO in Malaysia. And oh my god, finally, we were super happy and excited, and that was when we started to like, we need to step up our game, you know, like we need to stand out more as a fan club, we need to promote more, we need to find more CNC owners in Malaysia and unite, because we need to do this properly, you know, to get them to come here.
The CNCO album charts at 6. This is a really, like, to me, the peak of their career in Malaysia. They're not known yet in Malaysia during that time, during the release of their album. To chart at 6 on Malaysian iTunes is incredible. I would say it's very incredible. And I'm so proud of them. At a time, I was like literally screaming, and I was posting it on Instagram, Twitter, like everywhere. It was also the same time Solo Yo was released as a single. And Sony Music Malaysia tweeted about the album during midnight of the release, and they made their pin tweet and header CNCO, and they promoted it multiple times.
Hey yo Malaysia, we are CNCO! We can't wait to share our new album with you guys. Thank you for all the support so far, we love you so much.
Yeah!
Honestly, I am just so proud.
One of my favorite memories in CNCO Malaysia is when Joel mentioned they will do a promo tour in Asia country during one of the interviews in Teen Choice Award.
We're going to Japan, Indonesia, Malaysia, Philippines.
Not just Japan in the list, but he also mentioned Philippines, Indonesia, and
Malaysia! We are super excited to tell you that we are going to Kuala Lumpur to see you guys. Thank you so much for being so supportive, and we can't wait to meet you all. Stay tuned for more details.
Hey!
Yeah. Love you! Nice.
Love you!
See you soon!
If I were to choose between 3 days CNCO were in Malaysia, I would say during their arrival, because I was one of the first Malaysian CNCO owners they saw when they arrived in Malaysia. There were only 6 of us, and I'm so honored to be with them. I wasn't supposed to be there, as I thought I couldn't make it on time. But thank God I drove the 40 minutes drive, even though without any confirmation of their arrival or their when and where will we be arriving. Because I kept saying to myself, if I really get the chance to meet the CNCO
At least I get the chance to meet other CNC owners.
We are waiting at the airport. We are keep on update with your IG story, and I saw like such an update like I love Malaysia at the airport with the signboard. At that time I was like, they are here, finally. That's the best moment in my life. Like, I know they are here.
The first person we saw was Eric and his mother, and followed with Clara and Christopher, Zabdiel, Joel, and last one is Richard. They were behind the glass door waiting for their ride, and we were so excited to welcome them. And when we finally meet them, they thank us and we took a couple of pictures, and I get to talk to them. It's a really great experience.
The 19th of September 2018, 1 year since I discovered CNCO through Reggaeton Lento Remix, my 1 year anniversary of being a CNCO owner. That was the day CNCO arrived in Malaysia for the first time. Went to the airport with my friend Suriana. We were the first two to arrive, and we brought like a trolley of gifts. Bought gifts for each of the boys. Just the day before, we were looking for gifts for them. We arrived 2 hours before we actually got to meet them. So it was quite a long wait, and we didn't know what to expect. No idea if we were like waiting at the right airport, at the right place, you know, and if we were waiting at the right time, if we already missed their flight or whatever. Like, there was a possibility that they were at the other KLIA. Thank God, after 2 hours of waiting, they actually eventually showed up. We got everything right, we got everything perfect. It was like, oh my God, the feeling when I finally saw Eric first. I saw him first with Daisy. We've been standing there for like an hour or so holding the flag, the CNCO Malaysia flag. They saw us. We were like holding out the flag, trying to get their attention, and Eric actually caught us in his Instagram story, the one on the far left, holding the flag with Suriana. It felt so unreal when they finally see them in front of your eyes, and we were like, are they gonna show up or not? And you finally see them, and yeah, actually, well, that was definitely a very, very memorable experience in my journey of being a CNC owner, because it was my 1 year anniversary of being a CNC owner, and along with 6 other Malaysian CNC owners, we were the first to give them a hug. We were there to welcome them. It felt like everything has finally come full circle, you know, because for a whole year, I've been trying to get their attention, trying to get them to notice that they have fans in Malaysia.
When CNCO was in KL, I had a chance to join in the interview when Hype Malaysia contacted me randomly in the morning. I didn't have anything prepared. I was still finishing up my letters for them. I got to Garden Hotel and I got to join in the interview, and oh my God, was I nervous. Everyone there, Stony Music Malaysia and Hype Malaysia, they weren't as enthusiastic as I was, because I've been listening and following them for more than a year. I was the only one who was like a excited fan, squealing inside. When I met them, I was so speechless, starstruck. My heart was bursting out. They were so nice, Richard and Chris. Chris actually told me that he felt my heart beating when he gave me a hug, so that was really special. I got to watch them during the interview. I got to ask 2 of my own personal questions to Joel and Chris. One point I caught Chris staring at me, so that was special. You can actually see that in the video. That was just an amazing experience. I felt so happy following them for a year, and finally got to meet them, ask them and hug them and take selfies with them. They are so nice.
My most favorite memory would definitely be the showcase. That's when I first saw them live, and meet and greet was fun too. I can't believe I actually got a picture of them. Best part was I got to meet the other members of most of the other members of my family, the CNCO Malaysia family, and they're so sweet and I love them so much.
Obviously it's showcase. I saw Denise Chan. I recognized her from previously before that. Their singing was amazing. I won so many pairs of tickets. I brought my siblings, my mom. We really had a good time there. my highlight was the meet and greet. Getting to meet them personally, it just feels completely different. It just feels like so surreal. It's like, wow, you're meeting the people that you watch every single day. And it's like, wow, I can't really describe it.
I won the hangout session and I able to watch them performing live, and is it like exclusive? I able to have a chat like with Joel, Zabdil and Eric. You doesn't like just watching them, but you able to have a chat with them. Who doesn't love it? Tell me.